Morning, everybody. Austin here, Walleye Way. Just wanted to show you a few things the other night, or my first video I made. I said some things. I was going to show you how I cut the crawler in half, or on the spinner rigs, how I cut the crawler in half. And then, you know, some of the ways I hook it to get like a slow death wobble. You know, if you've never fished with slow death hooks or slow death rigs, you know, there's some things you can do. How you hook your crawler, you know. Can create resistance on your crawler, and that'll give you, you know, like a slow death wobble almost. I gotta shut off my bait cooler. That's pretty annoying. But we'll show you real quick. So anyone who isn't familiar with fishing with blades or spinner baits for walleyes, or they actually work great for panfish. We've caught huge bluegill, you know, perch too. You catch anything. Catch anything on a nightcrawler and a spinner. But here's what we were fishing with the other night. You see you got your first hook there. Second hook trails about 4 inches behind. So basically here I've got a gulp, just a 6-inch gulp nightcrawler. And I don't fish with plastics a lot. Nightcrawlers anyways, I should say. So your first hook, your hook closest to the blades here, let's say you want your slow death wobble, what I do is I hook it through, feed it about a quarter, so it covers about a quarter of the hook, and you leave like a nose of the nightcrawler hanging up above where your line is tied to that first hook. See how it's kind of, I didn't hook it perfectly in the center of the middle of the nightcrawler you see there. I kind of hooked it more towards the bottom or the side or the top of the nightcrawler. And that'll really create the resistance in the water, and that'll get your spinning motion. So as your nightcrawler is spinning, if you've never fished with like a slow death hook walleye fishing, you'll get like a wobble like that. The water, there's resistance on the front of that nose of that nightcrawler. That'll give you that wobble. Now I'll show you quick too, another thing, the double. So you get your second hook, you've got your ring on your nightcrawler there. If it's a real one, even these plastic ones, you wanna go back a little further because your nightcrawlers, you know, as you put them in the water, they stretch out. But with the real one, you wanna hook it right after their ring, the band that you see on them. You put that hook anywhere, just like a half an inch or maybe just a little behind that band that's on nightcrawlers. And then what I do when I'm fishing with live nightcrawlers is I will take my finger, I'll go back about an inch with, this is with live nightcrawlers now, inch and a half, and I'll pinch them off. Otherwise there's just too much nightcrawler hanging out there. You'll miss fish, you'll get bites, they'll suck on the end of that crawler. You'll lose your crawler, and nothing stinks more than having to re-rig nightcrawlers. So what I was talking about though, when I cut my nightcrawlers in half, so let's say this was a live one. So you got your first hook there, and then here I got my second hook in it. I will cut my live nightcrawler right at the front of that second hook, and now you've got like two tails there. It doesn't look great here with plastics, but with the live nightcrawler, you get that, you got those two tails dancing underwater. I don't know what it is. The first time it happened to me, we were just about done fishing. I don't know if I had gotten a panfish bite or something. Something tore my crawler, and we put her back down. We drug the crawlers for like another 100 yards, and boom, fish. And I thought, hey, we should keep trying this. And that's kind of how I started doing that. Cutting my nightcrawlers in half. But yeah, you get two tails. You got your end of your first one where you cut it, and then you'll have the end of your second nightcrawler there. Otherwise, you know, pulling blades is pretty simple. Obviously with nightcrawlers, you're gonna want the double hook, you know, you're gonna want the two hook setup. A lot of the times we'll pull leeches on spinners, you know, and then you can get away with just the single. Especially with these butterflies, those leeches, that can be a great tool in the summer to get your fish to strike when those walleyes get lazy or the bite slows down. You just want them to strike. They may not be hungry, but if you can get them, if you can find the fish and just get them to strike your bait, these spinner rigs or whatever kind of rig you're pulling, just like pulling crankbaits, you're just trying to create a strike. These spinners, though, they do a great job, especially in the summer. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys what I was talking about the other night, kind of creating your own slow death wobble and then cutting that night crawler in half like I just showed you. So hopefully that can help you. I know we're at the end of September, so these night crawlers, or the night crawler fishing, will probably come to an end for a lot of people. Actually, it already has. The lake we're going to today, we will probably only be fishing with minnows. I don't think I'll bring along a couple tubs of night crawlers, but we'll be pan fishing and probably a few walleyes too. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, just wanted to show you guys that night crawler trick. probably, like I just said though, most people are going to be going to the minnow bite. So anyone who's still fishing crawlers, or if you want to learn for next year, you know, those are just two real simple tricks that have helped me put more walleyes in the boat. That's all I got for you guys. Thanks for watching again. Take care. One more thing. You liked the video. I'll try to keep the content going or coming for you guys. Ice fishing coming around here in Minnesota. Probably tried to get some ice fishing videos for you, but I'll keep doing like the informational videos, you know, things that have helped me put fish in the boat. But if you liked the video, I'd appreciate it if you subscribe and just like the videos. Thanks again.